Today, the moon beckons us to return with peace and hope and unity. Through Artemis, we will learn the lessons needed to venture farther than ever before. Today, we press the door open wider still. From Apollo 17 to Artemis 1, we stand together, ready to chart a new course for history.
We had never done live streaming of 360-degree content, and we were very much attracted to that because with live streaming virtual reality content comes the promise of experiencing history at the moment it happens. When the Artemis launch was coming ahead, we thought it has to be that moment. You know, it has to be what we attempt here. Try to do a super polished, very well produced 360-degree broadcast. Completely different to what we've done so far, but a new opportunity to take a risk and do something that is going to make us learn a ton of things.
It was an extremely challenging project. It was something that no one had ever done before, streaming immersively, and we did it in up to 8K to not only our partner Meta through the Horizon Venues platform, but also to Domes of Planetarium. So all these things that we'd given ourselves as a challenge for the production were very, very daunting. We wanted to bring people to the launch pad of the Artemis I launch, closer than any human could actually get, and allow people to experience that immersively. We had to work with a lot of unknowns in the sense of we didn't know exactly when the event would take place. This rocket launch is the first time such a large rocket has ever been launched. It's very likely for it to scrub. Previous NASA missions, they had been like 20 scrubs. I really wanted to be sure we talked about every possible situation, technical, creative, right up to, you know, something terrible happening to the rocket before our eyes. It was really important to think about all the possible things that could go wrong and together figure out how to deal with them.
The cameras that were close to the launch vehicle, we would not have access to all the time. In fact, there was periods of up to 3 days that we were told where we would not have access to the cameras or the microphones. And that forced us to do everything remote, but not just remote, but to have some autonomy at the camera sites and for them to be able to operate and to protect those systems and with the weather you get down in Florida, which is high rains, high humidity, high heat. So we developed an environment protection system that was basically like a can that would open up that we'd have to actuate in order to shoot the scene. That also protected the cameras that we used on the site.
We had to create a series of applications that would allow us to control the different cameras and also the different aspects of the rig using the cellular network. So we need to have a complete system that could be able to control 6 different systems at the same time, deployed on 6 different areas.
Those kinds of innovations, not every production company has. When we're trying to innovate in terms of our storytelling, we find technological ways to make that possible. By the time we were on our third attempt, we got there in mid-November with our crew on the ground. The launch window opened, I think, at about 12:30, 1 a.m. It was in the middle of the night. And then there was a call about whether we should go live, whether there was a possibility of scrubbing. And we finally made the call to go live with the show. That was remarkable and wonderful. Once we knew that that launch was happening and that they were counting down, it was so exhilarating. And I put my headset on, and it was like a nuclear bomb going off. It had that impact on me. It was so powerful. The whole sky lit up. It was like daytime. And then the rocket was gone, and it was exhilarating because we didn't, you know, we almost didn't believe it was gonna happen.
And here we go. Hydrogen burn-off igniters initiate. 7, 6, 5. Core stage engine start. 3, 2, 1. Boosters in ignition. And liftoff of Artemis I. We rise together back to the moon and beyond.
When humans land on the moon a few years from now, I believe that audiences will want to be there in real time with the astronauts experiencing this moment as it happens. You know, if you look back at the Apollo 11 moon landing in 1969, you know, the eyes of the world through television were on those two astronauts that walked at the lunar surface. And it changed the course of history. It really defined the media of television. And we feel that there's an opportunity to do that with virtual reality as well, to make people present at the lunar surface through telepresence in real time. And we need to learn how to get there. We need to learn how to do that, you know? And so doing this event was a way to prepare for that future.